So the materials that we work in my lab, they're called metal organic frameworks, and they are kind of like honeycombs in which the holes of the honeycomb are very, very, very small, of the size of molecules. So this is a 3D printed model of one of those molds. As you can see here, the way the molecules are arranged are in such a way that they leave a lot of empty space in between, right? And that empty space, we can use it to store gases or to do chemical reactions inside. In this case, we're using it to carbon dioxide to diffuse inside and use sunlight to promote the reduction of that carbon dioxide. So the light will strike the material, the carbon dioxide is inside, and that energy that was captured by the material from the sunlight will be transferred to the CO2 to produce formate, and then it will leave. So it's like photosynthesis, in which plants pick up sunlight and carbon dioxide and turn it into a sugar. So in this case, instead of having a plant, we have a material like this that captures the sunlight and turn the carbon dioxide into something similar to sugar. This particular metal organic framework, or MOFs, is made out of titanium in an organic compound that captures a specific wavelength of light, in this case, blue light. So when this MOF captures the blue light and the carbon dioxide is stored inside, the blue light will add the energy necessary to reduce the carbon dioxide from carbon dioxide to formate. This can be utilized, for example, in a power plant. So a power plant produces a lot of carbon dioxide because it's burning coal. Right? And when it's burning this coal, one of the processes that the power plant does is called scrubbing of the carbon dioxide. So they separate it from everything that's being burned. A material like this, once carbon dioxide is being scrubbed, can be fed back into one of these materials, shine light directly from the sun, and add the energy necessary to produce more fuel. That carbon dioxide can be turned into a fuel, and that fuel can be fed up again onto the power plant. So then you can recycle your own carbon dioxide in your power plant, and that helps to reduce the emissions, to obtain energy, and to help fight global warming.